नमस्ते लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, इंडिविजुअल्स इन वेरियस मोमेंट्स। सो फार आई वाज टॉकिंग अबाउट वेरियस टॉपिक्स, नाउ लेट्स ट्राई अंडरस्टैंडिंग डांस एंड म्यूजिक फ्रॉम द फिलॉसफी and spiritual point of view. Though here the point is, one needs to have that vivid and wider aspect. The reason for this is, yesterday I attended one webinar session where I had a close interaction with Padma Vibhushan awardee, highest dignitary artist. She had a very vivid and a wider vision on this. Not taking the dance and music form from the what do you call philosophical or spiritual point of view. She was more or less focusing on the primary aspect of Paramananda or Ananda aspect. Absolutely, she was correct. Though over here we have that conventional way of presenting the dance form or the music form using the doctrines or whatever it is. The point is, one needs to go way beyond that. When I say way beyond that, one needs to really understand how exactly he or she would reach that highest realms. When I say highest realms, touching upon the Prakriti and Purusha as such. Unfortunately, in today's generation, maybe for some reason, we are still hanging on with that conventional ways. The point is, to what extent one can touch those conventional ways. Conventional ways work to an extent. Not to a large extent, because our human psyche is such that the psychology part varies as the age advances. When I say as the age advances, it needs to be nurtured, it needs to be put in a structured and a systematic way. It has to have that so-called scheme. When I say scheme, it needs to be like how this scheme or the structure is put across is a main point. The jolting point over here is, most of the dancers today are doing just for the sake of doing. Dance is all about transcribing and transforming the critical subject of Vedas and Upanishads by and large at a higher end. When I say higher end, that's it. No more, no less. I personally experienced this by empathizing and by trying to understand the core concept of it. I premeditated, I meditated on it from the ritualistic point of view, from the philosophical point of view, from the yoga point of view, whatnot. Every aspect of it. The standpoint over here is, how do you look at the subject? What is the subject, or what is the core concept that you are touching upon? And how is it going to the general public? Forget about Vilasini style, forget about Margi, Desi, whatever it is. What is the end result? The broader point over here is, how exactly it is touching body, mind and soul. Today, sorry about that. Today, if we see the pandemic attack or these unprecedented attacks that are happening to the humankind or the society as a whole, with one uniqueness or one unified concept, is that we are breaking the universal laws. When I say universal laws, universal laws. What happens is, the phenomena behind the doctrine, following the doctrine from the conventional practices, definitely yes, gives you mileage and it's a kind of study going on and you are following it. And what we are doing is, we are just trying to tamper that and reproducing that. Whatever that is, they are following those rules and regulations. Now, coming to the unconventional practices, if we see, one can touch the broader aspects if and only if he or she goes beyond a point. When I say beyond a point, beyond a point, beyond the point of doctrines. Why am I telling beyond a point of doctrines? Is that these doctrines or the trainers or the gurus or the teachers or the professors or the assistant professors, scholars, just give you the basic input of it. Understand this, ladies and gentlemen. This is not only for classical dance, art and culture. This is for every field, every individual in their respective domains. And that is one reason why we are failing to see the natural ability. And that is one reason why we are not able to touch those universal truths. Definitely, yes. One may argue how you are trying to interrelate both of these to art and culture to that. Yes, art and culture is nothing but study of universal laws beyond the point. I suppose most of you are well conversant with the puzzle of 9 dots, right? You can connect those 9 dots properly unless and until you go out of box. Is that happening now? No. That is one point of it. The second point of it, the Vedas or Upanishads are doctrines. They give you guidelines, definitely yes. They teach you the way of doing things. And the third is, they give you that kind of knowledge, the in-depth knowledge and the deeper aspect of the life or the phenomena of life or the philosophy of life. And the fourth and most important, they teach you the basic understanding of universe existence and coexistence. But to certain extent, if you are following Vedas and Upanishads doctrines or the structures or the scheme or the systematic processes as suggested in Vedas and Upanishads, it will give you that discipline. Understand this. Nothing more than that. This is one very important point which I could understand from yesterday's seminar on webinar where the eminent dancer spoke, who was holding a prestigious award of Padma Vibhushan. The point is, how do you get to that point is the question. Today, the art and culture state is just within the boundaries. It's not out of the boundaries. It is just happening that they are doing it for their own benefits. They are not thinking from the society perspective or the growth perspective of the universe, due to which the universal laws or the universal secrets are getting subdued, and due to which the universe is creating a lot of havoc. Ladies and gentlemen, this is high time. One needs to understand Shastra or the Natya Shastra out of the purview of that book, not from the dance point of view only. Definitely, yes, from the dance point of view, it would be really helpful for you. One needs to really have that focus. The other very important point, if I really look at the personality was talking about Vedic Indic civilization from the Tantra and Mantra point of view. When you want to understand Tantra and Mantra, you have to think out of box. and start experimenting. The point is, where do you start this? How do you want to do it? And there would be one more question that everyone would ask. Is Tantra and Mantra stipulated to only person who is going systematic and who is having that discipline or whatever? No. Tantra and Mantra can be followed provided he or she is following that diligently. And that attitude towards knowing the real truth and want to do something good to the society, that is important. When one is practicing Tantra and Mantra, he or she will have to follow that. There are certain mudras like this. This one, and this one, and this one, which you follow on a regular day-to-day basis. She was in fact emphasizing on this very much. I really appreciated this thing that she got that to the notice of the dancers, that you need to think beyond this. Dance is beyond the doctrines. Really wonderful. And she talked about sound of destruction and annihilation. What is the sound of destruction and annihilation? Why she had to get that to the point? The sound of destruction is nothing but towards the growth to the next level. Unless you do that destructive act within yourself, you will not be able to construct a constructive thought process or constructive scheme or the constructive application. Ladies and gentlemen, dancers in respective domains, musicians, individuals, this holds good even for the one who is into life coaching as well. It's a universal subject. Natya Shastra is a universal subject. At the same time, she talked about codification and decodification of mudras. What is this codification and decodification of mudras? Why do we need to codify mudras and decodify mudras? What are mudras? Mudras are nothing but your subconscious mind's thought process coming out as a resultant force. When I say resultant force, resultant output. Our hands itself have power. It gives rise to the conscious state and subconscious state. It talks about panchakoshas and panchabhutas. Panchakoshas and panchabhutas are nothing but the universal facts, the universal truth, equanimity of the universe. Once you take control over this, that's when you understand this, ladies and gentlemen. Natya Shastra, what I could understand from her detailed discussion in the video, in the seminar, was she was very clear on this point. Natya Shastra is definitely a doctrine, but one should go beyond the Natya Shastra. And then She talked about integration and reintegration of the old culture. What really is this integration and reintegration of the old culture? If we take Indic or Vedic civilization or Indus Valley civilization or Harappa and Mohenjo-daro civilization, they followed all the universal laws. They integrated whole of the idea of the universe as a whole, as a single unit and single entity. And they went beyond the doctrines or the beyond a point and expressed themselves. And that is one reason why there was some sort of happiness in them, and there was not much of the maybe there could have been these kinds of attacks or these kinds of things, but still they could manage. Why? Because they followed the universal laws. And this is one very interesting point the scholar has raised: integration and reintegration of the old culture, putting into the place. Yes, she had a valid point in that. And then she talked about Medha with Vedas or Vedas and Upanishads. What is this Medha? Medha is nothing but your application of mind. When I say application of mind, how you are using your subconscious mind, how you are using your thought process, how you are structuring, how you are realigning, how you are re-engineering your thought process is a very important fact. However, for these, all of these, in a simple terms, as a part of text, as a part of doctrine in Natya Shastra, they are talking, giving that technical jargon name like charis, vebicharis, etc., etc., etc. But in reality, if you really see, this is what is the fact. One needs to understand human science from this point of view. The pointers from this video or the key factors from this video to the individuals is Natya Shastra is not only doctrine for dancers in the field of fine arts and culture. It's a doctrine for the individual as well. And there is every responsibility, with due diligence, that a dancer needs to explain this concept wide and large, by and large, to the deep, in-depth analysis by giving him or her that kind of knowledge. Thus, I conclude this video with a positive note, pointers being understanding of the sound of destruction and annihilation, how to reintegrate and integrate the old culture, putting and thus putting in place, and talking the understanding the tantras and mantras by and large, onus lies on the gurus or the teachers or the guides for the individuals who are in practicing of yoga and meditation. Thus, I conclude this video with a positive note. Stay blessed. Have a blissful life. Have a nice day ahead. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. May the Guru's grace be with you.